Wow. It's oh my unique. Gosh.
You cannot believe it. It's unique. So, at the beginning, we start from the outside. This small part is reserved for the catechism. It's the place where the neo-catechumen who prepare their baptism are catechized here. They have the teaching of the gospel, about the life of the church, how to become Christian. So that's the part, the small part, reserved for the people who are preparing their catechism. After, when we go inside, we have...
Tell me the name and how old this church is.
Yeah. So, the church is so old. It's a pagan place at the beginning.
Pagan
at the beginning. And after the Christian, the Maronite church, when she arrived in the 7th century, the church was built. But the painted wall, that's from the Crusade period, the 12th century. The 12th century. If you look into the painted, we will go much more closer. You will understand the meaning of the catechism by painted churches. They have, first of all, we can read it from the outside to the inside. From the outside, you have the Old Testament with Abraham and his son, Isaac.
Yes, yeah.
So we have the sacrifice of Isaac, and we have the
lamb
behind him to take his place.
Yes.
And in front of him we have Moses with the tablet of the Ten Commandments. So we have all the Old Testament. Abraham, the first father of the faithful, Moses with the tablet of the Ten Commandments, and downstairs we have Gabriel with the Virgin Mary for the annunciation. So we have the Old Testament always and the New Testament. And he's bringing for her something new. He's telling her something new. So you will see three lines who go directly to the ear of the lady. That's the voice of God who will reach the Virgin Mary by her ear, and she has the small bird, that's the Holy Spirit, who will cover her to become Mother of God. So she's sitting in a place like a resident, she's a queen. She has the place of the queen. Like her son, after you see, he has the throne like a king. So she shared with her son the power and the glory. We have Old Testament, New Testament, but we still have the Christ in the middle, inside, and this opening window. That's the Christ, light of world. He's the light, and the first hymn that the Maronites started, by your light we get the light, O Lord of light. So, from this window, that we will see the coming light from the sun from outside, and they will start the liturgy at the morning. And they will show that the true light, that's Jesus Christ. So we have this outside. If we go inside, we have Jesus Christ on his throne, like a king, and he gives his benediction. In the same time, he opened the gospel on the gospel of John. I am the way, the truth, and the light. So, he gave his benediction, he looked to the person who's coming to the church, he's looking, he's fixing on the face of people, and he's surrounded by the false gospels. We have John, the gospel, that we mentioned like eager, because he go high in the spirituality when he write his gospel. From the opposite side, we have a human being, who represent Matthew, because he take in care the humanity of Jesus Christ. He speak how Jesus, he was so human. From this side we have the cloud, it show the doctors, and Luke was a doctor in the Old Testament, so he represent Luke, and we have Mark, who represented like a lion. So they are the four symbols of the four Gospels who will mention who's in the throne, Jesus Christ, who's in the middle. But from the both side, we have the Holy Mother, the Virgin Mary, not showing herself, she showed her son. We call him Pantocrator, who's sitting on his throne to have the authority of the governor. And from the opposite side, we have John the Baptist. So we have who represent the Old Testament, because he closed the Old Testament, and we have the person who started the New Testament, the Virgin Mary. So the pattern say that the New Testament and the Old Testament, they are showing who's the true light, Jesus Christ. So they are here. We have angels with a strange way to represent angels. If you count, they have what we call that, the middle, the arms. They have six and they have eight in this side with eyes. They are the cherubim and the seraphim, who hold in their hands a pancart saying Kaddish, Kaddish, Kaddish. They said holy, holy, holy. All the day they are singing the holiness of God. So from this side and the other side, the cherubim and the seraphim, they are singing one holy way, the holiness of God. If we go downstairs, we will find the same system as the Byzantine Church. When I explain for you, the 12 apostles, they are here. They have the same place in each representative church in the Pentagon wall. Peter is in the middle, from this side, because he's down directly to Jesus, and Paul from the other side, and all the 12 disciples, they are in the same place in each island. So we have Peter, we have Marcus, we have the others, Andrew, we have Paul, we have Matthew, all the 12 disciples that are here. If we go outside, it's the same. We have in the both side, Daniel in the Old Testament is a prophet, and Stephen is a deacon. They are mentioned, this both persons, Daniel from the Old Testament, Stephen from the New Testament, to say they have the martyrs between them. Daniel and Stephen, they get the martyrdom between them as a common point. So, and also, Daniel was used in the Maronite liturgy many times in the year. Now we don't have any reading from Daniel, but in the past days, he was with the book of Genesis, the first using. We use it a lot, the book of Daniel and the book of Genesis. And the personality of Stephen occupied a big place in the Maronite Church because he was a martyr for Jesus Christ. From outside, we have two cavaliers, two persons who have horses. They are Saint George, with the person who gave this donation for the church. We saw his picture. And from the opposite side, the patron of the church, Saint Theodore. He's a saint from the 3rd century, who is here hearing his from the army soldier for the Roman emperor. And we have the person who given this icon as a memory for them, the donator of the icon. So they represented the person who given, who paid in some way to have this icon in this church. That's the catechism of this entered wall for the church. We know that this window was opened without knowing how to restore the entered wall, so they at one so late they opened without knowing that they could restore the church. And for that we saw that the entered wall was damaged with the opening window. We didn't study it until now. The rest of the church is so small, but we don't know if they still have fresco pentagon for the other part of the church. But they haven't in the village a lot of old churches like this one. it's a unique church.